In a previous video, we've installed Oracle in a Docker container. But access to the Oracle instance was limited to command line tools. Today, we will see how we can run a graphical program from that container, so you will have a nice graphical tool to access your database. Before going into the practical steps, you must first understand the X window system is using a client-server architecture. The X server runs on the device attached to the display and is responsible for drawing things on the screen. On the other end, the client can run anywhere on the same host or remotely. When you work remotely or through a virtual machine, you will use a network socket as a communication channel. But for local communications, you may use a more efficient Unix domain socket instead. For example, here you can see I'm currently running several X servers on my computer. And there is one dedicated Unix domain socket to connect to each of them. There are chances on your own system there will be only one running X server, probably listening to the X0 socket, but this is not mandatory. After this little introduction, let's go now to the container configuration. We will start with the same command as in your previous video, but this time we will add a bindMand to share the X server Unix domain socket between the host and the container. Now let's start the container. And while Oracle is starting up, let's open a new shell in the context of the same container to perform the necessary configuration tasks. The first thing you can notice is, thanks to the bindMand, the container can see the Unix domain socket required to connect to the X server running on the host. You can convince yourself those are the same file system objects by comparing the inode numbers. Since it is never a good practice to work as root, I will immediately create a new user account on the container. This new user should be able to start the Oracle SQL Developer tool, which is buried deep in the Oracle directory hierarchy. As you can see, that startup script is only executable by the members of the DBA group. So let's add the new user to that group. At this point, we have a communication channel to access the host X window server from the container, and we have granted the necessary permissions in the container for our user to run the Oracle SQL Developer tool. So let's see if it works. Oops. Apparently, the tool complains the display environment variable is not properly set. As we've seen at the start of this video, nothing prevents you from running several X servers on the same host. So the purpose of the display environment variable is to identify which X server you want to connect to. For now, let's define that variable with the same value as currently used on the host. And let's try again. And oops again. But this time, this is not the same error. It seems now the X window client libraries are missing on the container side. Let's fix that. Was this the only missing library? No. At least another one is required. So we will repeat the same process until we've installed all the required libraries. Unfortunately, this is still not working. But the error message has changed again. Now the software complains about not being able to connect to the display. Worth mentioning, it may work at this stage on your specific Linux system. But if it does, this is only by accident and because some Linux distributions allow over-permissive display access by default. So let's see now how we can achieve a more reliable configuration. Being client-server, the X Windows system must implement some access control strategy to ensure only authorized clients can connect to the display. There is two widely deployed access methods, ExOst and ExOth. I find ExOst too coarse-grained, so we will look at ExOth instead. ExOth uses a password-like authentication method. That means it will grant access to the X server for any client that can provide the necessary secret key. Here is the secret key currently used by my server. With a setup, we just have to export that secret key to the user account in our container. Once done, ex-client applications running there may have access to the host ex-server, just like clients running directly on the host. Okay, apparently the magic cookie was properly updated, so let's start now the SQL developer tool in the container as our configured user. By the way, you may notice I export here the current host display environment variable to the container from the command line. This is a much more robust solution than hard coding that value, especially if you are running several X servers, just like me. And you may have to connect from any of them. And success! As a final step, let's try to connect to the Oracle database instance. While perfectly integrated into your desktop environment, SQL developer is running from the container, the same container as the one running the Oracle database instance. In other words, from the SQL developer tool perspective, the Oracle database is running on the local host. For the same reason, if you save files from SQL developer, they will be saved into the container. And this will be your challenge for this video. Using a bindmount, just like we did to share the X-Window Unix Socket directory, could you share another directory that could be used to exchange data between the host and the container? As a hint, I would suggest you may need to create a new container with a slightly different configuration, but I'll let you think about that by yourself. As of myself, I'm looking forward to reading you in the comment section below.